Representative Longietti, want to say thank you, first of all, for taking the time out of your busy schedule to chat with us. And today we want to talk about special education funding. It's not only a statewide issue, but it affects many constituents in your legislative district. I understand that you've been appointed to a special commission to tackle this issue. Can you tell me about that?
Sure. Well, we passed legislation, what was called House Bill 2 of 2013, signed into law by the governor as Act 3 of 2013, that set up a special education funding commission, 15 members, one of the members from the House, to look at and to issue a report on how we should fund school districts in regard to special education, something that desperately needs to be done in the Commonwealth.
Yeah, and can you tell us how exactly special education is funded now and why that particular system might be broken?
Sure. Well, for many years, school districts essentially were all treated the same in Pennsylvania. It's assumed that 16% of the school population are special education students. Now, for some school districts, they may actually have a smaller percentage. For others, larger. I know school districts in my legislative district have seen growing populations of special education students. And so they're really not, the funding they receive really doesn't reflect that. So what the commission does is it sets a baseline, and it picks the 2010-11 school year as that baseline. And basically, this funding formula would only go into effect as we add new dollars in for special education funding. And so we would actually count the number of special education students in a school district. And that's part of what the funding formula would do.
And you were saying that the population of special education students is growing. So I would imagine coupling that with education cuts that we've seen in recent years, especially in your district, would create a problem for a lot of teachers and students.
Certainly does, and it's something that's beyond the control of school districts. They don't have an ability, really, to control what percentage of their students are special education. The other thing that this commission would do is we would actually break it down into three categories. Not all special education students are the same. And so category one would be your more average special education student. Then category two would be what we would call a mid-level. They need more services than the average student. And then category three would be an intensive. We see certain cases where students really need an intensive amount of special education services. Now, in the legislation, there is safeguards built in so that whatever formula we come up with, we don't encourage school districts to overclassify a student as category three so they can get more money. So those safeguards are in the underlying legislation that the commission will work off of.
Okay, so it sounds like you're really trying to meet students where they are to make sure that they get the best resources for them.
Absolutely, and we certainly need to look at adding dollars to special education funding. It's been static now for 6 years, and we know that school districts are seeing more and more special education students, and the cost per student is rising significantly. So we need to address that. The funding formula that we would work on and establish, a recommendation that is, would be to address those new dollars that hopefully will flow into the system. Well, now, ultimately, the General Assembly needs to approve that funding formula.
And you hear all the time that it's so important to give students the resources that they need so early on, because later on, you know, that's only going to help the state's economy and other industries as well.
Yeah, and we absolutely have an obligation to provide a fair and efficient system of public education for all students, including special education students. So it really is a Commonwealth obligation, along with local school districts, to make sure that these students have the resources that they need to succeed in life. And we know, too, with No Child Left Behind at the federal level, that the mandate is there for us to make sure that those students, too, are achieving adequate yearly progress. So the obligation is there. It needs to be done. And I'm looking forward to the commission getting started. We're going to have our organizational meeting this week. And we have a short timeline. We have to produce a report by September 30th of 2013. So we'll produce that report, and then the General Assembly will have an opportunity to examine it and work on it.
Okay, so I imagine you'll have hearings and meetings over the summer and within the next couple of months.
Yes, part of this commission is to actually to have public hearings and to get input from the public. We want to make sure that we're just not insular to Harrisburg and that we reach out across the Commonwealth to areas like where I live in northwestern Pennsylvania and beyond to make sure that we do the very best job that we can.
Great. Well, Representative Longietti, thanks so much. And I'm sure we'll be hearing more from you about this particular issue within the next couple of months.
Thank you very much.